Welcome to the Campervan channel, the YouTube channel for all things VW camper. Not surprisingly, this channel features campervans based on all generations of the legendary VW transporter that's been built for over 70 years. But as I'm making this video, it's incredibly 30 years since the launch of the T4, or the Eurovan as it was known in North America. The launch of the T4 in 1990 marked a massive shift from the classic transporters of the past and set the format for all the modern transporters of today. So this is a bit of a 30th birthday look back at the T4, a basic introduction to the model and a look at what it did for the campervan. Of course, the VW Transporter had evolved and improved ever since its launch in 1950. Original splitties had morphed into the more rounded looking T2 bay windows. Then, controversially at the time, the bays gave way to the hard-edged angular T3s or T25s. While each of these classic generations looked very different, they all had one thing in common: engines in the back. And apart from some of the very late T3s, air-cooled engines at that. But that was about to change. VW spent over 2 billion marks developing a radically new and completely revolutionary fourth generation transporter. When the T4 was launched in September 1990, shock horror, the engine was not only water-cooled, it was in the front. To make space for the powerplant and its gearbox, the previously flat front of the transporter had grown a nose with a small bonnet. There were many petrol and diesel engine options during the lifetime of the T4, with a huge range of power outputs. Powerplants included early versions of turbo diesel injections, or TDIs, which have become a mainstay of modern transporters. Automatics and eventually synchro four-wheel drive became available. The T4 also introduced a range of key features that are so familiar to people who use them for campervans, they might be excused for thinking they'd been there forever. It was the first time a transporter had been offered with two wheelbases. Short wheelbase vans were 4,707 mm. Long wheelbases stretched that a mere 40 centimetres to 5,107 millimetres. And while that 40 centimetres doesn't sound that much, it translated into a huge increase in volume inside and a much roomier feel for the campervanner. Another new option of a high roof added 19 inches to the height of the van. It gave much more cargo space inside and extra headroom for the campervanner, and no need to get a pop top. The T4 offered sliding doors on either or both sides of the van, and at the back, the choice of barn doors or a tailgate. These additions, the new body layout and the kind of modular body system, allowed VW to offer a tremendous range of body configurations and options. Dropside cabs, double cabs, flatbacks and tippers, for example. All this flexibility and extra space wasn't just good news for commercial buyers, it was great for people who wanted to use the T4 for leisure. Motorhome manufacturers were quick to build on the T4 chassis, including the mighty Winnebago in the US. And the first VW commercial to be officially given the name Transporter was ideal for compact campers too. VW sold a whole range of T4 California campervans during the model's lifetime. But these weren't factory built. They were T4s adapted by Westfalia, a German coach building company that had cooperated with VW since 1951. The T4 Californias were very well equipped, with many versions including the Highway, Biker, Beach, Joker, Blue, Advantage, Generation, Event, and Freestyle. And just for the record, it wasn't until 2003 that VW started to build its own Californias in-house based on the T5. In 1996, the T4 had a facelift, not because anything was sagging, but mainly because the nose had to be extended to make room for a much larger 2.8-litre V6 engine. Initially, only caravels and multivans had the longer nose, since these were the only models available with the VR6 engine. And short and long noses were produced at the same time for a while, just to confuse us. The revamp meant early T4s are now often referred to as T4As, and the facelifted models, T4Bs. For the spotters amongst us, the early T4s had rectangular front grilles and headlights and orange indicator lamps. Facelifted TBs had what's often referred to as the happy face, with a more smiley radiator, tapered wedge-shaped headlights and white indicator lenses. Glad we've got that sorted. By the time the T4 came to the end of the line in 2003, VW had built nearly 2 million of them. And although it was very different from its classic predecessors, the T4 has a growing fan base. The run-out limited last edition models and the V6 versions are particularly sought after by enthusiasts. So this video has been a bit of a 30th birthday celebration of the T4, but stay tuned to the channel because we've got more T4 videos coming. A buying guide, finding out exactly what they're like to live with, and how they convert into campervans. So please subscribe, click on that bell icon, and you'll be the first to know when those videos are published. For now, thanks for watching.